Thank you. Thank you very much. It's great to be here. And first, I want to thank Christine Quinn, not only for that really nice introduction. Turn your umbrella upside down, folks. Some of you know the song. But for being the courageous, hardworking, dedicated leader that she is, and she can and does appeal and work with and lead every New Yorker, whether it's the west side of Manhattan from which she comes from, or Staten Island in working class precincts. Christine Quinn is an amazing leader. She's done a great job in the council, and the best for her is yet to come. Now, I want to thank Marla Hassner and Lewis Bradbury, our co-chairs. I want to congratulate the Pride Agenda's new executive director, Nathan Schaefer. Now, I told some of my staff I was going to say good old reliable Nathan, and they said only about 20% of the audience my age would know where that's from. Raise your hands. How many of you heard of good old reliable? Yeah, about 20%. It's from Guys and Dolls. Anyway, Nathan, I admire the work you did and have done at GMHC fighting to repeal the ban on gay men donating blood, among your other efforts. Your energy, your policy expertise, and most of all, your joie de vivre as you make the fights is something our community needs and makes you a great leader of this organization. We're ready to follow you, Nathan. Keep up the good work. Now, the last year has given us a lot to celebrate. Chris mentioned her and Kim's wedding. It was a great party. As Chris will tell you, I danced the night away. A few of you have mentioned reading a certain New York Times article about me. But for those of you who don't know, I absolutely love weddings, especially when the happy couple met while working in my office. But yes, we do have a lot to celebrate this year. The movement that began on Christopher Street late one June night in 1969 took us all the way up the Hudson last year to Albany, where thanks to your savvy and sweat, we achieved what so many had yearned for. Marriage equality in the Empire State. I want to thank Empire Pride for the hard work, the grit, the dedication, so that all New Yorkers now have the freedom to marry the one they love. At long last, the love that couples like Chris and Kim share is recognized by New York State. As Chris mentioned, I have been proud to bring more diversity to the bench. Justice Etkin is already proving to be a great judge. I'm proud that Ali Nathan is now on the bench. I've seen some of the decisions she rendered, and she understands justice. Her nomination, as some of you may remember, during that time, the forces of hate reared their ugly head, outright bigotry against Ali on the floor of the Senate. But we worked hard. And we prevailed, they didn't. We will always prevail, and they won't. And now I've nominated Pamela Chen, and I can't wait to see her as well complete her confirmation process and join the bench as well. The nominations send a clear message to young gay teens from Buffalo to Brooklyn that the sky's the limit. Your sexual orientation will never stop you from realizing your fullest potential. On the national front, we celebrated the implementation of Don't Ask, Don't Tell. After a decade of serving in the shadows, brave gay and lesbian members of our military are now able to serve with pride, with dignity, and with the respect they've always deserved. And in state after state, rights are advancing. In court after court, discriminatory law after discriminatory law is being called into question. There's no question about it. Equality is on the march. And the undeniable truth is we now have great momentum. The wind is at our backs, and as the great Martin Luther King Jr. famously said, and as some of you know, I take my megaphone in the Gay Pride Parade and shout it to everybody. The arc of history is long, but it bends in the direction of justice. The arc of history is long, but it bends in the direction of justice. And today, of course, is National Coming Out Day. From coast to coast, teenagers are mustering the courage to utter those daunting but liberating words, "I'm gay." They look to you as role models, and I know that you're setting an example to which to aspire. And of course, we know that the fight for full equality is far from over. The forces of bigotry that oppose equality are motivated, well-funded, and aggressive. One of the things we're working on is ending discrimination in our immigration laws. I'm the sponsor of the Uniting American Families Act. You know, since the days of Ellis Island and before, immigrants to this country have followed loved ones across oceans. Rather than trying to interfere, government needs to encourage stronger families and stronger support systems, and we will get this done, hopefully this year, in the next year in the Congress. We also have to make sure that the Supreme Court, we have to do all we can to get the Supreme Court to make sure they strike down the so-called Defense of Marriage Act. I hope and pray that those 9 men and women on the court will come down on the right side of history. And after all, it's not only the right side of history, it's the correct interpretation of the United States Constitution. But rest assured, if they fail to arrive at a correct interpretation of the 14th Amendment, we will carry on the fight in Congress until we succeed and repeal DOMA. So, in conclusion, my friends, my dear friends here, through the good times and bad, you've always been there, toiling away. Your efforts are now bearing fruit and will bear more. I'm confident of it. And as we move ever forward and ever upward, rest assured that I will continue to be with the Pride agenda and all who support its efforts in the struggle for full equality. You are my brothers and sisters, and we all know that the arc of history is long, but it bends in the direction of justice. Thank you.